If you have been missing our videos, then this is the video you want to watch because we have jam-packed some of the best SEO tips we have shared on this channel, so you won't be missing out. And you be the judge. Let us know if these are helpful. Let's go. So we have shared many SEO tips and strategies over the years, and we won't be talking about the common ones we always share, like consistently updating your content at least once a year, having proper heading hierarchy when writing your content, topic authority, URL structure, and all the basic stuff. We are sharing little known SEO hacks that you may or may not have heard of before. So let's start with the first. Do you know that you can do a lot with the site colon operator? Let's start with the most basic function. If you want to know if a page is indexed or not, for example this page, as it is one of the newest blog posts on our site, then all you need to do is to copy the URL, go to Google, and type site colon, and paste the URL here. Do not leave any space after the colon, and hit enter. If you see a search result like this, it means that the page is indexed. But if you see something like this, it means that the page is not indexed. That's the most basic function. And then if you want to find YouTube shorts that share AI tips, you can do site colon youtube.com space in URL colon shorts and then the quota keyword AI tips. And as you hit enter, check this out. These are the short videos that talk about AI tips. The key is in the in URL function. If you check out the URLs of these shorts, it contains the word short in it, as you can see. And that fits the operator here. And this keyword lets Google know what type of short videos you are looking for. And then let's say that you want to find pages from RankMath that contain the word ChatGPT. You can search site colon rankmath.com and code the keyword ChatGPT. And it will show you all the pages that contain the exact coded keyword. If you don't add the code, Google will find pages that relate to the keyword or phrase you have added after the domain. And then if you want to further extend the function, say you only want pages that are published after March 1st this year, right at the back of the operator, you would add after colon 2025 March 1st. And here are all the pages published after the date that contain the keyword ChatGPT. And if you only want pages where the SEO title contains the keyword, you can add in title colon before the keyword and code this keyword. And as you can see, the SEO title of this page contains ChatGPT, this as well, and this as well. Following that, if you are a brand strategist and you want to know if multiple news sites have mentioned your brand, you can add site colon bbc.com space at the or operator and then site colon cnn.com space. For example, you are the brand strategist for OpenAI. The keyword you are looking for is OpenAI. And this will show you all pages from these two websites that have mentioned the company name. Another thing you can do is to find competitor pages that cover a specific topic. For example, site colon, our competitor is Yoast, and the topic we want to focus on is AI SEO. And here are all the pages that our competitor has covered based on the topic. Now, if you want to find your government's published annual report for research purposes, you can add site colon .gov.sg, where you are looking for pages from the Singapore government. Your government's official domain will be different, so adjust it accordingly. And then you are looking for PDF using this operator and any PDFs in the government site with annual report in them. And here you go. These are all the PDF reports you are looking for. Also, if you want to look for guest post opportunities in the email marketing niche, you can search email marketing in title colon write for us. And here are all the sites in the email marketing niche where you can reach out for a guest post. And if you are in the eco-friendly niche, you can change this to eco-friendly. And here are all the sites that accept guest posts in the eco-friendly niche. So these are some of the cool things you can do with the search operators on Google, and of course, there are many more use cases than what I've shared. If you want to find more use cases, you can visit this page and check it out. I'm pretty sure you'll find them useful. Now, this strategy is meant for large language model optimization, and it is based on the data we have collected from an original research. We have shared that in this video right here. Large language models like ChatGPT don't care much about search engine rankings when generating response. Instead, they rely on how semantically relevant or contextually related your content is to the query being asked. So in traditional SEO, keywords like best WordPress SEO plugins for beginners, best WordPress SEO plugins for local businesses, best WordPress SEO plugins for bloggers, and others will be optimized into one long comprehensive article targeting one main keyword, which is best WordPress SEO plugin. But the strategy for LLM optimization is to create content targeting each keyword separately, regardless of how similar the content is to the comprehensive article. Because if the content is contextually related to the intent of the LLM query, the content will have a higher chance of being used. However, in traditional SEO, these pages are called thin content or duplicate content because the contents are somewhat similar, which goes against best SEO practices. So what we will do is to add canonical tags on these separate pages, telling traditional search engines to rank this instead of the other pages, while still optimizing for LLMs. This way, you're optimizing for both traditional search engines and large language models. Again, this is a strategy we have formulated based on an original research we have done, so feel free to try it out and let us know if it works for you. If you are new to on-page LLM SEO, the easiest way to start is to shift your mindset from writing for humans and Google crawlers to writing for humans and language models. In traditional SEO, search engine crawlers read the whole page and understand the context of the nearby text, but large language models like ChatGPT or Perplexity don't process the entire page at once. They read in chunks. This means your key points need to be self-contained and entity-rich within each section so that even if LLM reads just that part, it still understands the full meaning and associations between the entities. Entities are things. For example, me, I'm a person. This is a mic, it is an entity. I'm pointing at my camera, the camera is an entity. So when you're explaining something for the LLMs, you want to pack all related entities into one sentence or paragraph and give the entities a meaning. For example, when we write an article about what is voice search optimization, in traditional SEO, you will write naturally and spread out the entities. Like all these highlighted tags are entities. This is fine for traditional search engines because it will read the entire page and understand it. But for LLMs, they don't read the entire page. They read in chunks of text. So when writing for LLMs, you want to pack all the related entities into one sentence or paragraph and give meaning to them that explains what is voice search optimization. The same idea applies to abstract terms. Instead of saying adding visual elements make content easier to scan, where you have probably described what visual elements are on other parts of the page, you want to be specific for LLMs, such as adding lists, tables, headings, images, and other visual elements makes content easier to scan and understand, where lists, tables, headings, images are entities. And you group the entities as visual elements. By naming the entities, you are giving the LLM multiple angles to understand what visual elements really mean. It's like labeling ingredients in a recipe instead of just saying add spices. So when you are writing an article in the AI search era, you need to write for three parties: humans, search engines, and LLMs. And the way to do it, especially when you have a question in the heading, is to pack the first sentence or paragraph with related entities, making it entity-rich, ready for LLMs to parse, and optimize it in a way you do for featured snippets, which means keeping it short, punchy, and straight to the point, answering the question. So the sentence or paragraph after each heading should be optimized for LLMs and featured snippets, while the remaining paragraphs are meant to explain further for humans and traditional search engines. So what do you think about these large language model optimizations? Let us know in the comments down below and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Now, especially when you have a huge site with hundreds or thousands of blog posts, when you update your content, the search engines may not immediately know about the update, although they claim otherwise. Then days, weeks, and months may even go by, and you still do not see any changes to the search rankings. So the way to know if your updated page has been acknowledged by the search engines like Google is to visit its search console. On your search console, under indexing, go to pages, and click on View Data About Index Pages. From here, you can sort the pages according to the last crawled date, assuming that you have updated this page recently in October, but it has been a month since the search engine robots crawled the page, then you will need to take action. Click on the page, click on Inspect URL, and then Request Indexing. Give it a while, and that's it. Come back to the Search Console to check it again in the next couple of days to see if the page has been crawled. Now, this is not the only thing we share about Search Console. Let's check out the next. Google Search Console is more than just a tool to track clicks and impressions. It is a powerful way to uncover long-tail keywords that can bring targeted traffic to your site. To find question-based queries on your Search Console, go to the Performance tab and make sure that the Queries tab is selected. Then you want to add a filter and select the Query option. Following that, select Custom Regex. Regex is the short form of regular expression, and it is used to filter keywords that match a certain condition. So we will add a filter like this to filter keywords that start with either one of these words. As you click Apply, you will see a list of keywords that start with either one of the words that we have defined. You can optimize the related page with these keywords in the FAQ section. And if you are looking for commercial queries your site is ranking for, that includes words like best, top, versus, etc., let's remove the previous filter and add another regex filter. You can use this set of operator that find keywords your site is ranking for that includes these words. As you hit apply, you will see all commercial keywords your site is ranking for. And then if you want to find keywords of a certain character length, you would add a filter like this. This will show you all keywords that are between 10 to 30 characters. And if you hit apply, here we go. These are all the keywords between the character length. Feel free to adjust the length over here. Now you can also filter based on the keyword length instead of character length. If you want 1 to 2 word queries, you can add this filter and it will show you all the keywords you are ranking for that contain 1 to 2 words. If you want medium tail keywords with 2 to 3 words, you can use this filter and it will show you all the keywords with 2 to 3 words. And if you want a search console to show you long tail keywords with 4 words or more, you can use this filter. And here are all the keywords your site is ranking for with 4 words or more. For 5 words or more, you would just plus 1 to this number. And you will see keywords with 5 or more words. Honestly, I'm just scratching the surface with this. There are many more filters that you can apply in a Search Console, and if you want to check them out, then check out this page. The same link is in the description. Now, there is a lot to talk about for image SEO, but I will keep it as concise as possible. We will first talk about the featured image of your post. We recommend having your featured image in the dimensions of 1200 pixels in width. If it is a horizontal image, then 1200 pixels in width and 628 pixels in height. If it is a squared image, then 1200 pixels by 1200 pixels. These are the recommended dimensions if you want your content to be featured in Google Discover. On top of that, you want to set the meta tag of the featured image to max image preview large. As a rank map user, this is done for you by default, so you don't have to do anything extra. On any of the posts, you can find that setting in rank maps tab and in the advanced settings, right here. This is the local or page level setting. But for the global setting or the default setting, you can find it in rank maps titles and meta settings. And in the global meta, you will see the image preview set to large by default. Plus, you should avoid having your site logo as your featured image and make sure that the featured image is not pixelated. Now, that's for the featured image. Now let's talk about the general recommendations for images. We recommend adding image alt text to all your images. An alt text is a string of words that describes the image. For example, we have this image on a page. Let's right click to inspect it and you will see that the alt text is right here. Edit your robots.txt in RankMath. This is great for accessibility because for visually impaired individuals, the screen reader will read the text that describes the image. And if you have optimized the file name of your images before uploading to your site, RankMath will automatically use the file name as the alt text so you don't have to do additional work. If you are using RankMath, even the free version, on RankMath's dashboard, make sure that you are on the advanced mode. You want to make sure that you turn on this image SEO module. And in Rank Math General Settings, click on Images. And if this Add Missing Out Attributes feature is turned off, you want to make sure to turn it on and use the file name as the alt text and save changes. Other than the alt text, the more images you add to a page, the slower the page loads. So it is important to keep the file size of each image as low as possible to prevent bloating up the page size. We recommend keeping each image below 300 kilobytes regardless of the dimensions. On top of that, serve your images in WebP or AVI format because it provides smaller file size and higher quality visuals, which improves web performance and user experience. We recommend installing the Imagify plugin to optimize your image file size and serve your images in modern image formats automatically. It's totally free to optimize images up to about 200 images per month. So for a simple blog, it's totally free for you to use Imagify. But if your site is like a news website where you publish hundreds of articles a day, you can use Imagify with no limits with its infinite plan. So that's the basic image SEO tips. If you want to dive deeper, you can check out this video right here. Anchor text is the text that hyperlinks to another page. This text describes what the link page is about. For example, this link is about Meta Tag Analyzer. It tells the visitor to expect the next page to talk about Meta Tag Analyzer. So if we click on it, here we go, this is the Meta Tag Analyzer 2. So the thing is, you don't want to overuse the same anchor text across several articles. For example, let's say that you have an article about smartphones for students, and you link to a page about best smartphone brands using the anchor text smartphones. Then in another article about basic smartphone photography guide, you add a link to a page about smartphone camera tips, again using the same anchor text smartphones. Later, when you publish an article about budget smartphones, you link to a page about affordable smartphone models. And once again, you use the same anchor text, smartphones. Now, if you were a search engine, you will probably be confused too, right? The word smartphones technically fits all these pages, but each page is about a different aspect of the topic. So it's better to use specific and descriptive anchor texts that ideally include a keyword that matches the page focus. So when linking to a page about best smartphone brands, use the anchor text best smartphone brands. When linking to a page about smartphone camera tips, use the anchor text smartphone photography tips. And when linking to a page about affordable smartphone models, use the anchor text affordable smartphone models. This way, search engines clearly understand what each page is about.
One more thing. While descriptive anchor texts are great, you also don't want to over-optimize by using the same phrase repeatedly. Keep some variety.
For example, if you have already used best smartphone brands once, the next time you could use alternatives like top smartphone brands, leading phone manufacturers, or most popular smartphones.
Optimizing your anchor text may seem subtle, but it is actually an effective way to build context around your published content. So on top of all these tips and strategies we have shared, creating content others have not seen before or information gained that could come from a fresh angle, original research, or sharing first-hand data and experiences that are hard for others to replicate. And also, focus on content creation in other formats such as long-form or short-form videos, podcasts, etc. So these are some of the best SEO tips and hacks we have shared over the years, and if you have any others that you think are useful, let us know in the comments. Our channel is all about helping you grow your brand traffic, and if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.